So, sorry I haven't checked in with you for the past couple days here on the Walnut Show. It's been raining a little bit here in the New Zealand. I was in Auckland for the night and it poured, and it was pouring the next day, so Auckland wasn't a lot of fun. So let me preface by saying these next couple minutes will be strictly informative. There will be no shenanigans, and there will be no hoopla, if you will. Just a couple things I've learned about the NZ, being here about a week now. So this is more for the kids that if you ever do come this way, here's some lessons learned. Important lessons for you and your wallet. Lesson one, the gas out here, hell of expensive. And that's because they import everything. Like, I put 20 New Zealand dollars in, and I don't think I got a quarter of a tank. And me and my crappy little car, probably costs about 80 bucks to fill. So if you're in a camper van or something, I can only imagine what gas is running you, because it's got to be ridiculous. So that's lesson one. I've been on this bus now for a couple days. There's pros and cons that I've noticed. Pros and cons for the bus. I'm a guy that likes to do my own thing and get out. You know, here I am in a field in the middle of nowhere by myself. Just cause I can, cause I want to. And on these big bus things, you don't really have a lot of leeway if you want to do your thing a little bit. You're on this bus and the itinerary is like rock solid. And they pass out these little sheets of information and things for you to sign up and do, and everything is very, do this, do that, do this, we gotta book the hostels, we gotta do that, and we gotta, and it's good if you want everything done for you. But me personally, I like to get lost, I like to screw up, I like to live a little bit, and it feels like everything is hand-fed to you. Where's the adventure in that? I don't want to be hand-fed in life. I mean, at least up until I'm 10. But yeah, I want to see a little bit. I want to get out. I want to run around. So you don't have a lot of flexibility with the bus tour companies, and I'm sure they're all the same. And what's great is that everything is taken care of for you. So if you're the kind of guy that doesn't want to do any of the hard work, kind of like my dad, and you want everything done for you, well, then that's your bag, baby. That's what you do. Me personally, I like to wing it and run around and see what's what. So the bus tour, you know, like I said, it's a big money maker out here. It really is. Like, there's three or four companies and they zip you all around, you know, get you to see the cool stuff and all the touristy stuff and where you want to be. But you kind of miss out on, you know, the nothingness, the relaxation. Every day you got to do an activity, you got to do something, you got to run around, you got to sign things. And it's like, yo, I'm on vacation. I came here to relax, see nothing, do nothing. And sometimes it doesn't feel exactly like a vacation. It kind of feels like you're on like a school trip or a school bus. It's always something to do, always something to sign. Other than that, the music's fine. It makes me feel like I'm in 95 all over again. But yeah, the bus tour, you know, they give you the good discounts and you kind of take their word on everything. And that's just some of the things I've learned. I mean, Mercury Bay we hit up, but it was rainy and cloudy and kind of crappy, so the beach day wasn't much of a beach day, but there's nothing you can do. You got to leave. Next day you got somewhere else to be. So your beach day was kind of wah, 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 whatever. Where else did we go? After the beach, we went to Rotorua, and I am butchering this the words and the language out here, by the way, butchering. We went to Rotorua, and there was some thermal geysers, kind of like Yellowstone, which were kind of cool to see. It stunk like hell. Smelled like bad feet, which probably what my feet smell like right now, because I stepped in a bog. So that was kind of cool. Right now we're at the Watamo Caves, which I got nothing to do for the day. They had a couple activities, and somewhere along the line, something got screwed up as far as scheduling, so they can only take half people in the caves today and half people tomorrow at 7 a.m. Uh-huh. This guy don't get up at 7 a.m. Not me. Oh, but how do we make it fair? Let's pick names out of a hat. I wasn't picked. I was kind of having one hell of a day. Really. But, so I got nothing to do here in Watamo, which is the only thing to do is the caves. And, yeah. So I'm here with nothing. Food's a little pricey, too. Beers are actually pretty reasonable if you like to get your drink on. All beers are $4 or $5. All drinks are about the same. There's really not a lot to do, so drinking is kind of the only thing. And a lot of the hostels are dry hostels. I say a lot. Everyone I've been to so far, I'm assuming the whole country is dry. 28 years old, and I can't have a drink, like, on my own, legally. I can't just, oh, yeah, yeah, here's my... No. I don't know what the hell that's about. Can't even have a drink. I feel like I'm 14. You can't make a drink. Blah, blah, blah. All right, okay, whatever. Luckily for me, I don't really drink much. So yeah, dry hostels. And the thing is everything's booked for you on this bus tour stuff, but you can book your own hostels. You can go, like, on the internet, which, by the way, the internet. Internet and booze is really how these New Zealanders make their money with this bus tour stuff. Internet is like $1 for 15 minutes most places. Talk about cranking up the money. Internet, hostels, bus tours, booze. That's the money, because there's nothing else really out here to do. But anywho, the internet is, you can go on and book your own hostel while you're with the bus tour, which is kind of nifty. So if you check out, like, Hostel World or something and, you know, book something close by on your own, you might be able to save yourself a couple of bucks. But, yeah, man. Most of the hostels are nice, pretty clean, pretty reasonable, nice people. A lot of single travelers, which is kind of cool. A lot of people are out on their own out here, kind of just meeting people and going. It's a different experience to travel by yourself, let me tell you. It forces you to meet people. And that's kind of a wacky thing for some. It's definitely not easy, I'll tell you. I mean, it's weird and awkward, but it's adventurous and fun at the same time. A little spontaneity never hurt anybody. So yeah, a lot of single travelers, a lot of young kids doing this bus stuff. I'm sure they're all basically identical. They all kind of go to the same touristy spots, which is all there is to do, really. I'm hoping the South Island is a little less to do, a little less running around. But, yeah, we're in the caves today. Tomorrow we're going to Taupo. Some people are doing skydiving, not me. I'm going to wait till the South Island. Yeah, then we're on to Wellington. Might try and catch a rugby game, which I still don't understand. I don't know what the hell's going on with rugby. And then there's a couple, there's a hike I'm going to go on. Mount Doom, apparently, from Lord of the Rings. It's like an 8-hour hike up into the mountains. I am not in shape for that. Let's hope I make it back. There's a couple other hikes in the South Island I plan on doing. Because that's really why I'm here. I'm not here for the boozing and the internet. I'm here for the hiking. And, you know, getting out a little bit. Seeing stuff that I can't see in the U.S. So that's my informative information guide to New Zealand a little bit. And if you're not big on having everything set up for you, the camper vans, if you have the extra cash, the camper van's going to be a great way to go. You don't have to book any accommodation. You get to sleep in these camper vans. They're like, you know, depending between 50 and 100 bucks a night, plus gas. You save on hostels. Camper vans, you come and go as you want, where you want. So if you have the money, that's probably where I would recommend. But they probably get pretty pricey. But it's got to be a pretty cool thing to do, the camper vans. Fortunately, I don't have that kind of scratch, so. But yeah, bus tour, pros and cons. Definitely noticed some things. You know, and the person driving the bus, it's not only a bus driver. It's like tour guide, guiding you places and what to do and where to spend your money and how to do it. And sometimes it makes you wonder, like, you almost feel like they're steering you in one direction. That's the only direction you can go. So it gets kind of interesting sometimes. where I'm like, yeah, but I don't want to do that. Oh, you should totally do that. Yeah, but I don't want to do that. No, 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 you got to do it. Be my mother? I don't have to do anything. To wash myself. That's it. That's all I have to do on my vacation, wash myself. I can barely do that. Cripes. So yeah, that's my informative New Zealand guide. On the North Island a couple more nights, and then we head down to the South Island. So hopefully the weather's going to stay nice. It's a beautiful day today, hanging out in the little field here. And hopefully we're going to keep on trucking, doing what we got to do. Shooting stuff for you kids and enjoying it. So I will check back with you. I will see you later. Peace.